My safety plan against domestic violence. Various photographs have been used in this booklet. These will be acknowledged at the end of this booklet. My safety plan against domestic violence. Department of Justice and Constitutional Development, Republic of South Africa. National Prosecuting Authority, South Africa. National House of Traditional Leaders. Table of Contents. Personalized Safety Plan, page 2. What is a safety plan? Page 2. Why do I need a safety plan? Page 2. What are the important things I must consider? Page 2. Is it necessary to revise my safety plan? Page 2. Me and my safety. Page 3. Step 1. My personal safety needs. Page 3. Step 2. Safety when preparing to leave the shared residence. Page 3. Step 3. Safety during a violent attack. Page 8. Step 4. Safety in my own home. Page 9. Step 5. Safety with a protection order. Page 9. Step 6. Safety at the workplace, school, or in public. Page 12. Step 7. Safety and drug or alcohol abuse. Page 13. Step 8. Safety and my emotional health. Page 14. Step 9. Telephone, toll-free, and cellular numbers I must know. Page 15. Page 2. Personalized Safety Plan. What is a safety plan? A safety plan helps me to identify action steps that I must take in order to increase my safety and that of my family against domestic violence. I know that domestic violence occurs when my abuser subjects me to any of the following forms of abuse. Bullet. Physical abuse. For example, when I am assaulted or threatened with violence. Bullet. Sexual abuse. For example, when I am raped or forced to perform or watch a humiliating sexual act. Bullet. Emotional, verbal, and psychological abuse. For example, when I am subjected to constant insults, ridicule, or name-calling. Bullet. Economic abuse. For example, when I am prevented from earning any income. Bullet. Intimidation. For example, if I receive threatening and fearful messages or SMSs. Bullet. Harassment. For example, when I repeatedly receive phone calls or am being constantly watched to cause me fear. Bullet. Stalking. For example, when the abuser repeatedly follows me or demands to talk to me against my will. Bullet. Damage to property. When the abuser intentionally damages my property without my consent. And, bullet, any other controlling or abusive behavior. I can draw up my safety plan when I have identified the slightest possibility of any of these forms of abuse towards me. Why do I need a safety plan? I need a safety plan to help me avoid or minimize any violence against me, because I may not always know when violence will occur. What are the important things I must consider when I develop my safety plan? Bullet. Before I develop my safety plan, I must list all the things that may expose me and my family to danger now and in the future. Bullet. In my safety plan, I must set out action steps that I can take in order to increase my safety and that of my loved ones. Bullet. The action steps must be easy and quick to do in a safe way. Bullet. I must keep my safety plan in a place where the abuser cannot find it. Bullet. It is not necessary to write my personal details on my safety plan in case it falls into the wrong hands. Page 3. Me and my safety. Compile a document containing the following information. 1. Name of my key rescue organization or person. 2. Their telephone or cell number. 3. The local police station. 4. Its telephone or toll-free number. 5. The date of issue of my list. 6. Revision dates of my list. Safety and my personal needs. It is important that I list all my personal safety needs in my plan. Step 1. My personal safety needs. Make a list of all your personal safety needs. I may use some or all of the action steps suggested below, depending on how relevant they are to my situation. I may also add some new steps that I find necessary to increase my safety. Step 2. Safety when preparing to leave the shared residence. If I share a residence with the abuser, it is important that I develop an escape plan to help me leave the scene quickly and safely. I must also ensure that the abuser does not know of my plan and where I will be escaping to. In drawing up this plan, I may use some of the following suggestions. 2.1. I must get an escape bag that is small and easy to carry, and keep it in a safe place that I can quickly reach when in need. 2.2. I must pack my escape bag with all items I will need when I leave the shared residence. 2.3. If I am an elderly or disabled person, I must also get a whistle or anything I can easily use to raise an alarm. Page 4. Checklist of items to take when leaving a shared residence. When I decide to leave the shared residence, I must take with me certain important items. I must prepare these items and put them in a place where I can quickly grab them all at once. Make a list of your important items and tick where appropriate. 2.4. Items. Planning for me. Item. Identity book or driver's license card or passport. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item. Refugee or work permit. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item. Certified copy of protection order or any relevant court order. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item. Medication or medical prescription or medical records or medical aid, hospital or clinic card. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item. Duplicate keys, for example, for house, car, escape venue, office, safe, etc. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item. Taxi, bus, train ticket or fee, or rental car fee? Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: cash or bank cards, for example, ATM card, credit card, savings card, check card or book, etc. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: old age pension or disability or child support grant card. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: public phone card or alternative cellular phone SIM card or pocket telephone and address book. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: birth or marriage or divorce certificate or antenuptial contract document. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: insurance, bond or lease contracts or title deed and other related documents. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: business or work-related documents. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: essential clothing items. Are they packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: other. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Page 5. Planning for my children or dependents. Item: school uniform, books, reports, and other related items. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: children's favorite toys. Are they packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: essential clothing items. Are they packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: birth or adoption certificates and other related documents. Are they packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: medication or medical records or cards. Are they packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. Item: other. Is it packed in my escape bag? Yes, no, not applicable. 2.5. If necessary, I may have extra clothing or items kept elsewhere by a friend, rescue person, or organization to avoid escaping with a heavy bag. Make a list with the full name of the person or organization and their telephone or cell number. 2.6. I will visit local organizations or specialists that provide services for victims of domestic violence and, with their assistance, decide which services I need. 2.7. I will visit local shelters to apply for accommodation I may use after I have left the shared residence. I will also ask how they operate and choose the one that will best suit my needs. Compile a list that includes the name of the shelter, the telephone or toll-free number, or the cell number of the contact person, and the services you will need. Page 6. 2.8. I must choose an escape place that is easy to reach and unknown to the abuser. If I am an elderly or disabled person, I may also need a person who will accompany me to my escape place. I must also choose a night escape place that can be quickly and safely reached. Make a list that has your first escape choice and contact details, your second escape choice and contact details, your night escape place and contact details. 2.9. I must alert my rescue person at the escape place or places that I may arrive without notice. If possible, I must arrange with them as to how I will gain access into the premises. For example, know where house keys are kept. Make a list explaining how I will gain access into the first escape choice, how I will gain access into the second escape choice, how I will access my night escape place. 2.10. I must ask at least two rescue persons to seek relevant help whenever the abuse occurs. For example, when they hear strange noises coming from the place where the abuse usually occurs, or when they receive an alarm from me. 2.11. I must teach my children and other people I trust in my residence about how to get immediate help before or during an attack. For example, by calling police or signaling my rescue person or organization. Make a list with the following information: name of person or organization, their contact number, the type of assistance that is required or expected. Example 1. Local police. Contact number 10111 or 1112. Type of assistance, to come quickly and arrest the abuser. Example 2. Ambulance. Contact number, type of assistance required. Page 7. 2.12. I must decide on a secret code phrase, word, or signal that I will use to communicate with my rescue persons when I need immediate help. Rehearse your secret code with your rescue persons. To avoid confusion, it is advised that you use one code with all of them. Code phrase. Example: we have that rehearsal. Code signal: send a blank SMS or missed call, blow a whistle 3 times, etc. Code word: shout CPI, which your rescue person would understand as meaning call police. 2.13. I must identify from my residence or any other place where violence usually occurs the low and high risk areas, as well as the quick and safe escape route. I must thereafter practice how I would safely reach the low risk area and escape route without making the abuser aware of my intention. Make a list including the following information: high risk areas, low risk areas, quick and safe escape route. 2.14. If the abuser sexually abuses me in our house, I will take measures to avoid being alone with him or her. For example, I will move to a spare bedroom, change door locks, use a key block, etc. Specify how you would avoid being alone with the abuser. 2.15. If I am an elderly or disabled person who was abused for the social grant, I will find ways of protecting my money from theft or robbery. For example, keep my ATM card in a secret place, unknown to the abuser. Change my ATM PIN number. Give my ATM card or money for safekeeping to a person I trust. Keep my ATM card separate from my PIN number, etc. State the action you will take to prevent this abuse from occurring or recurring. 2.16. If the abuser has access to my phone, I must ask my rescue persons to block their names and numbers from appearing on the call display by dialing #31# followed by my number. I must do the same. Then the word private will appear on the phone screen of the person called. 2.17. If it is not safe to use my phone, I may use a public phone, a private or secret SIM card, or cell phone, or any other safe and fast way of contacting my rescue persons. 2.18. To minimize danger around me, I must ensure that I clear every room of all items that the abuser may use to harm me during an attack. For example, scissors, display knife holders, dangerous ornaments, etc. Page 8. 2.19. Before I leave, I must find ways of making money to secure my financial independence. Identify your passions and skills, and then decide what you will do in order to earn money. For example, bullet, get a job or start a small business. Bullet, ask for money from certain persons or seek financial help from certain agencies, for example, National Youth Development Agency. Bullet, open a secret savings account with a financial institution, for example, bank, post office, etc. Bullet, apply for a maintenance order at the local magistrate's court for the maintenance of myself and or minor children. Bullet, when applying for a protection order against the abuser, I may also request the magistrate to impose an additional condition that orders the abuser to make regular payments of a reasonable amount of money towards the maintenance of myself and or minor children, or, bullet, do any other thing to help me gain my financial independence. State this thing. 2.20. I must constantly rehearse my escape plan to see if it will safely work when it is time to escape. I must also periodically review it with my counselor, rescue person or persons, or any other relevant person to ensure that it provides me with maximum safety at all times. Page 8. Step 3. Safety during a violent attack. In order to increase my safety during a violent attack, I may use some or all of the following suggestions. 3.1. As soon as I sense that there will be a violent attack, I must move to a low-risk area and towards my escape route. For instance, I must move away from a kitchen where there are knives, pens, or similarly dangerous instruments which the abuser may use to harm me. 3.2. With or without being noticed by the abuser, I must quickly raise an alarm to alert my rescue persons of the attack. I may use my secret signal or take any other action that is quick, safe, and most suitable at the time. 3.3. When it is time to escape, I must use a quick and safe escape route. 3.4. I must quickly take my escape bag and other light items I plan to leave with, and then escape when it is safe to do so. 3.5. If the situation is very serious, and it is very dangerous to escape or raise an alarm, I must do whatever possible to protect myself until I am out of danger. I must always keep in mind that there is always a way out from every situation. 3.6. I must alert people at my escape place that I am coming, or request them to provide me with the necessary assistance to ensure that I get there quickly and safely. 3.7. Once I am at the safe place and have sustained injuries from the attack, I must immediately call for medical assistance. Call for an ambulance. Or call the police to quickly take me to a medical practitioner. 3.8. If possible, I may ask a friend or any person around to take photographs of my injuries for the purposes of using them as evidence in court. 3.9. I must keep any clothing item or property that got damaged during the violent attack, as they may form part of essential evidence in court. 3.10. If I have been sexually abused during the attack, I must not take a bath or wash or dispose of any clothing item that I had on. Otherwise, I will be washing away evidence that may be essential for DNA purposes. Page 9. Step 4. Safety in my own home. It is not always possible to avoid the occurrence of a violent incident in a residence shared with the abuser. Even when I do not live with the abuser, I must take some or all of the following safety measures to avoid or minimize harm against me. 4.1. If the abuser has or had the keys to my residence, I can change the door and gate locks as soon as possible. I can also ask the court to order him or her to return all my residence keys and prohibit him from possessing duplicates thereof. 4.2. I can improve the security system in my home, for example, by installing an alarm system, erecting iron bars on windows and doors, or putting additional locks and key blocks where necessary. 4.3. If I have my bedroom to myself, I can share it with a person who is aware of the abuse so as to avoid being alone with the abuser, for example, my sister, friend, or any other person I trust. 4.4. If the abuser is no longer staying with me, I can ask people I trust to call me or the police should they see the abuser entering my premises. 4.5. I must teach my children, caregiver, helper, or any person I stay with about what to do when the abuser enters my residence or any specified part thereof without my permission or in violation of the protection order. List the things you will teach them to do. For example, call the police at 10111. 4.6. I must teach my children, daycare or creche teacher or school teacher about what to do when the abuser abducts or tries to abduct them. That is, take them away by force. Without my permission. List the things you will teach them to do. Page 9. Step 5. Safety with a protection order. I know that the law allows me to obtain a protection order against the abuser. Should I decide to get this order, I must take some steps to ensure that it is issued. It is also important that I take some measures to ensure that this protection order is legally enforced should the abuser break or violate it. The following are some of the steps I can take. 5.1. I must seek all information regarding the process of applying for a protection order, either from the prosecutor, clerk of the court from Domestic Violence Division, police, social worker, counselor, traditional leader, or any other relevant service provider. I must know where and how to obtain a protection order, and also when and how it will protect me. The law demands that I must receive this information in the language which I understand. 5.2. If I'm a minor, that is, below the age of 21 years, the law allows me to apply for a protection order against the abuser with or without the assistance of my parent or guardian. 5.3. If I cannot personally apply for the protection order by reason of fear, anxiety, depression, or sickness, I may authorize in writing any person who has a material interest in my well-being to make this application on my behalf. This person may be a relative I trust, a counselor, social worker, police official, doctor, boss or supervisor, teacher, etc. 5.4. If necessary, I may ask the magistrate, not to disclose my new residential address when issuing this order, or, bullet, not to allow the abuser to enter my residence or shared residence. Shared residence means the house or a place I share with the abuser. Page 10, 5.5. If I have already obtained a protection order against the abuser, I may apply for an amendment of such order to include the above prohibitions or any of the following prohibitions. Other prohibitions, conditions, and obligations. After each, indicate whether yes, you need it, or no, you don't need it. A. Stop the abuser from entering any part of the shared residence, for example, the main bedroom or any other room in the house. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. B. Order the abuser to contribute towards the payment of rent or mortgage attached to my residence or shared residence. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. C. Stop the abuser from entering my workplace or school. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. D. Add a condition to my protection order that a police officer accompanies me to the shared residence to collect my personal belongings. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. E. Direct that my new residential address be omitted from the protection order so as to prevent the abuser from knowing where I stay. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. F. Remove any firearm or dangerous weapon from the possession or control of the abuser. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. G. Refuse the abuser access to our children if it will be in the best interest of our children to do so, etc. Yes, I need it. No, I don't need it. 5.6. The abuser commits a crime even when he or she violates an interim protection that was properly served upon him or her. 5.7. If the abuser violates the protection order, open brackets, whether such order is interim or final, close brackets, I must take the following steps to have the order legally enforced and the warrant of arrest executed by the police. Step 1. I must immediately report such violation to the nearest police station or alert my rescue person or any person I trust to provide the necessary assistance. Step 2. I must produce to the police my certified protection order and suspended warrant of arrest. If I do not have these documents with me, I can ask the police to contact any person or police station that has copies thereof, or if possible, request the police to take me to the place where I keep them. Step 3. The police will either give me Form 10 to complete, or assist me to write an ordinary affidavit stating how the protection order was violated by the abuser. I must not withhold from the police any important information regarding this crime. Step 4. I must provide the police with full names of eyewitnesses or persons who have knowledge relevant to this crime. Page 11, 5.8. The police may also provide me with assistance in the following. Bullet. Accompany me to collect my essential belongings from my residence or any other place. Bullet. Take me to a safe house or escape place if it will be dangerous to continue to stay at my house or shared residence. Bullet. Remove any firearm or dangerous weapon from the possession or control of the abuser if such firearm or weapon was used or threatened to be used in the violation of the protection order. Bullet. Take me to a doctor when necessary. Bullet. Give the necessary support to my children or dependents, etc. 5.9. Besides the police, I may contact the following person, organization, or government department for necessary assistance. Make a list that includes who or what to contact and at what number or numbers. A. Head office of the National Prosecuting Authority or local office of the Senior Prosecutor. Telephone number 012-845-6000. B. Local Magistrate's Office. At what number? C. Community Police Forum. At what number? D. Non-governmental organization, open brackets, NGO, close brackets, or community-based organization, open brackets, CBO, close brackets. At what number? E. Any relevant community safety organization. At what number? F. My counselor or social worker or lawyer or legal advisor, etc. At what number? G. Office of the Independent Complaints Directorate. At what number? H. Any other person or organization. At what number? 5.10. Should the case be taken to court, I know that I have the responsibility to give evidence in court for the state. I must cooperate with the prosecutor until my case is finalized. Failure to do so may result in the abuser being found not guilty. Page 12. Step 6. Safety at the workplace, school, or in public. When I am at my workplace, school, or in a public place, I may do some or all of the following measures to increase my safety. 6.1. If my protection order prevents the abuser from entering my workplace premises or any specified part thereof, I must provide the head security or my boss or supervisor or shop steward or any relevant person with a certified copy of the protection order, as well as a recent photograph of the abuser, if necessary. 6.2. If I am a student, I must provide the school head security or principal or any other relevant person with a certified copy of the protection order that prevents the abuser from entering the school premises or any specified part thereof. If necessary, I must attach a recent photograph of the abuser to this order. 6.3. When going to or leaving my workplace or school, I can ask a friend, colleague, or any other person I trust to accompany me to my car or train, bus, or taxi station. I must have at least 3 safe buddies on whom I can rely for this purpose. 6.4. If I use public or private transport, I can take the following measures to increase my safety. Make a list of these measures. 6.5. If the abuser knows my shopping routine, I can use different places, days, and times of shopping, or always do my shopping with a person I trust. I can also take the following steps to increase my safety when I am in a public place. Make a list of these measures. Page 13. Step 7. Safety and drug or alcohol abuse. I use alcohol or drugs, and I know that the use of these substances can reduce my ability to act quickly or wisely to protect myself and my dependents from or during an abusive incident. However, I can take the following steps to increase my safety. 7.1. I abuse alcohol and or illegal drugs to forget about my abuse. I am aware that possessing illegal drugs is a serious crime. I also know that I may not be able to beat my alcohol or drug abuse on my own. Therefore, I must seek help from relevant specialists or organizations. The following list contains the name of a person or organization and their contact details. A. South African National Council on Alcoholism and Drug Dependence, open brackets, SANCA, close brackets. 011-781-6410 or 012-542-1121. B. Alcoholics Anonymous, open brackets, AA, close brackets, 086-143-5722. C. Employee Wellness Program, insert contact details. D. Other, insert contact details. 7.2. Whilst I still struggle with the abuse of alcohol or illegal drugs, I can also take the following protective measures. Make a list of these measures. 7.3. If I use legal drugs to cope with depression, anxiety, strength, or for any other reason, I will ask my doctor to suggest other coping mechanisms that will increase my safety. I may also join a support group, local gym, or participate in any other relevant healing program. Page 14. Step 8. Safety and my emotional health. I know that this abuse has affected my emotional health. I have lost some courage, hope, and self-esteem. To restore my emotional health and avoid further difficult emotional challenges, I can do some of the following. Tick where applicable. 8.1. If I feel sad or depressed, I can A. Take a walk or drive. B. Swim or do any sport activity. C. Do gardening or farming activity. D. Go to church or pray or sing. E. Read an interesting book. F. Volunteer in community activity. G. Cook a new or favorite recipe. H. Take a bath. I. Wash a car or watch TV. 8.2. If I feel sad or depressed, bullet, I can talk to a person who really cares and is always supportive of me. For example, a counselor, psychologist, spiritual leader or pastor, support group leader or member. Bullet, I can repeatedly do positive self-talk. For example, I'm a survivor. I'm a good parent. I'm beautiful and lovely. I am an achiever. I'm useful. I'm successful. I'm brilliant. I'm a good provider. I'm strong. Bullet. I can meditate or think about one special thing that will make me feel good about myself. Bullet. I can do other activities that would make me feel good and strong. Page 15. Step 9. Telephone, toll-free, cellular numbers I must know. List here all important numbers. 9.1. Make a list that includes the following information. Person or place, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. A. Police station or community policing forum. Toll-free number 10111 or 1112. Telephone number, cellular number. B. Lawyer or legal advisor. Toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. C. Ambulance or paramedics, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. D. Local hospital or clinic or private or family doctor, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. E. Health-based organizations, for example, SANCA, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. F. Community organizations, Bullet, Childline, toll-free number, 0800-555-555, telephone number, cellular number. Bullet, Stop Gender Violence Helpline, toll-free number, 0800-150-150, telephone number, cellular number. Bullet, National Counseling Line, open brackets, Lifeline, close brackets, toll-free number, telephone number, 0861-322-322, cellular number. G. Street committee or neighborhood watch or neighbors, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. H. Counselor or psychologist, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. I. Traditional leader, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. J. Pastor or spiritual leader, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. K. Work or boss or supervisor or rescue person or friend, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. L. Other, toll-free number, telephone number, cellular number. Photo index. The following is a list of photographs that appear in the booklet. Cover page. Various hands holding each other in support. Page 12. A pair of clasped hands. Page 13. A close-up shot of a lady's left eye. Page 14. One picture shows a lady sitting comfortably, surrounded by cushions while she reads. The second picture shows a close-up of the left eye of a younger woman. For more information, contact Bullet, Chief Directorate, Promotion of Rights of Vulnerable Persons, Department of Justice and Constitutional Development, Private Bag X81, Pretoria, 0001. Telephone 012-315-1670. Website www.doj.gov.za. Bullet, SOCA Unit, National Prosecuting Authority, Private Bag X752, Pretoria 0001. Telephone 012-845-6000. Website www.npa.gov.za. Bullet, National House of Traditional Leaders, Private Bag X804, Pretoria 0001. Telephone 012-395-4640. Website www.nhtl.gov.za.